I'm back.
You guys, it's been so freaking long since I've posted on this channel. And I just kind of wanted to update you guys on like what's going on, what I've been doing in my life. So I really just been chilling. I got a new apartment. I ran through two cars. I had two cars, right? My last car was a Mazda CX-9. And by the title of this video, you can see, I got a new car. But, hold on, you guys. I had put on some lo-fi, but I don't think I could multitask like that. But, yeah, by the title of this video, I had got a new car. But I have to wait till Tuesday to pick it up. And right now, it's Sunday, the day before Labor Day. So Tuesday we're gonna go pick up my car, and I just wanted to make a video like post pickup day, because my last car, my Mazda CX-9, like it was kind of like a ghost whip. It really wasn't like registered or anything. You know, I'm only 22, and so I really didn't have that much buyer's experience or whatever buying a vehicle. So I was kind of just like, I don't know, not that smart with my money the last time. And I had my car last year of 2020. I bought my Mazda last year of 2023. And it got towed by the city this year, of 2024, like around June. And now it's September 1st. So, my car has been gone for June, July, August, September, like 3 months it's been. Boy, it's been a long 3 months, and I'm just so happy, my ear fucking hurts. So I'm just so happy that, you know, that I get to get a new car. And I just really wanted to make this video for my future self and just for you guys, because this time it's gonna be done right. I got the paperwork, got the title, the bill of sale. Last time I did not do that. Like, I swear, my last car was just like a ghost whip. So I'm just really excited to document this, you know, this experience. And I will post a video, or I will post another clip after this Tuesday. So I'm not too sure when this video will drop, but I just wanted to document it because, yeah, I'm so excited. I have worked so hard, and I have been praying so hard to God. Just so hard to God. I'm like, God, please, if you help me get a car, I'm gonna change my ways. So yeah, it's so crazy, but I just wanted to make this video post getting my car. But besides my car, I just wanted to catch you guys up. I think the last time I posted, my dad had just passed. After my dad had passed, I was living in an apartment. I was living by myself, but it was just like really like roachy in there. Like, it really wasn't the best living condition for any human, I'm gonna say that. So I think that's why I didn't post for a year. But within that year, I had gotten my dad's car for my first car, and then I traded that for my Mazda CX-9. And during that time, I really just have been like doing modeling and like photo shoots. I really haven't been doing too much music. You know, I really have just been healing, going to therapy. You know, I don't know, I was kind of gonna save this for a separate video, but I am kind of struggling with like cocaine use. And so I have been going to therapy within this whole year, just really just been healing myself over time. I recently just got my CT scans done on my nose, because my nose had been hurting, and I found out that I have a dislocated septum, and I have nasal polyps that I have to get surgery for. So literally, this is what I mean. The other day, I was literally praying to God. Like, this is like August. I'm just gonna say dates. August, September. I mean, August of 2024. literally, like, last week, I was praying to God. I was like, God, please, I will stop doing cocaine if you get me a car. Like, I promise. And that's one thing, like, I made a promise with my therapist. That's one thing she suggested, and I really think this is gonna help, because I'm like, wow, God really answered my prayers. And I say that to say this, like, just the cocaine use just really messed up my nose. I'm gonna have to get surgery right now. My wisdom teeth are coming in, and it's just a lot of pressure. My ear's hurting, but other than that, I'm grateful to be alive. Fuck all that. But you know, the rest of 2024, I do want to spend the rest of my 22-year-old life just being me. Just, you know, healing, being my most authentic self. Try to be clean. Like, that's gonna be my biggest goal. You know, maybe vlogging more would help, you know? I'm gonna try to leave the comments on, you know? I usually don't keep my comments on for social media. My hands are dirty, you guys, because I dyed my hair. Let me show you guys my hair. But other than that, yeah, so just wish me luck in my journey type stuff. But yeah, other than that, things have been pretty good. Like, I turned 22 in 2024. I moved into a different apartment, thank God. Oh my God, I might do an apartment tour. I don't know, let's see. But this apartment is just so much nicer. I feel like it matches my vibe, my aesthetic. It makes me feel so safe. It's so cute in here. You know, but getting into this apartment was so hard and so stressful for like 4 months, like, no cap. Like, it took over my whole summer. Oh yeah, you guys, I'm still in school. I might do like a school vlog or something. But I'm in a new apartment now. But like, anyways, like, that shit was just so fucking hard. Like, this, I've had other apartments before, but getting into this apartment has been so hard. And you guys, I'm just kind of happy, like, I'm just in a safer space now that I can, like, actually be clean, you know, like, be comfortable, be cleaning, like, off, like, sober, and just somewhere, like, where I can relax and just, like, heal myself, because I do have a lot of PTSD, and that's what I'm going to counseling for. So yeah and sorry if I'm talking slow. I'm just like trying to like work on my speech, you feel me? But you guys, I want to show you something, hold on. So I got a Hello Kitty blanket, and I just want to show you guys how cute. Hold on. Other than everything else, like, life has been good. Getting this new apartment has been a stressor. Losing my car has been a stressor. I lost my car because when I moved into this apartment, these apartments are kind of strict, and I didn't have no registration, no license, no like valid tags. So the city towed my car, so that's how I lost my Mazda CX-9. It's been a long 2 to 3 months, but I just wanted to give you guys an update, and we will see you Tuesday when we get the new whip. And I just wanted to give you guys an update on like where I've been, and I just wanted to document this, because this is gonna be like my first big girl official purchase. So yeah, you guys, bye. Hey, what's up, you guys? I got my ring light here. I'm trying to set my phone up really fast so I could talk to you guys. You guys, it's T minus like 24 hours. I'm about to watch Netflix, but the time is T minus 24 hours, maybe even less, before I go pick up the car. And you guys, I am so fucking excited. Like, I can't even tell you. You know, I haven't been using cocaine. I've been smoking though, a little bit of reefer. But you guys, it's been great. I've been so excited. It's probably about like 11 p.m. the day before. We're about to go pick up the car tomorrow at 5:30. You know, I'm just really grateful, you know. Damn, I just whipped my head here. But let's see. But you guys, you know, I think also another thing too, when I had my Mazda, I really wasn't driving that responsibly. I kind of blew out my cylinders, like my spark plugs, just from me driving crazy. So I also made a promise to God to drive more responsible, more slower, and stop doing coke. But you guys, I really have to live up to the end of my promise, and I really can't even explain to you the joy that I feel. Like, I've never really felt this way, and instead of me being like, I know it's just my PTSD lizard brain talking when I say this, but instead of me being like, oh my god, something bad is gonna happen, this is that, like, I've been really hopeful, really excited, all the signs have been around me, like, this is really about to happen. And you guys, I'm just so excited, I'm just so blessed, like, I really have been praying for this, and now I can go to school, and now it's gonna give me motivation to, like, graduate and finish school. But I really just can't believe this is happening, really, because I had been praying to God, and I had been telling God, like, God, please help me, please help me, please help me, and God knows, God freaking knows, you know, the situations I've been through. God has seen my tears, God has heard my prayers, and, you know, it's time for me to elevate, it's time for me to grow up, and I'm just excited, and I forgot what I was gonna tell you guys, but, yeah. Look, you guys, I bought balloons. Because I plan on taking pictures. After I am finished. Or after I get the car. But it's going to be a big investment, you guys. And I'm so excited. And I just can't believe this is happening. Like, I don't know. I know one day I'm going to be famous. I know one day, like, I just know, like, I'm gonna be famous one day. I just know. Because just how God has been treating me now, how everything has been working in my favor, oh yeah. But, you know. And it may seem like things that come easy, and it may seem like I'm like kind of like bougie and spoiled, but in all actuality, like, I'm really not. And I work really hard for my stuff, and I've been through through a lot of things in my life, and, you know, I'm starting to barely like realize that I deserve everything good that's coming my way, because it's been a lot of hard work, like, mentally and physically, just to get where I'm at, to be in this position, this clear-minded position. So now I'm starting to see I deserve everything good. And you know, I almost dropped my blunt, just fucking my bitch. But you know, in some ways, in all this therapy, in some ways it kind of feels like a little like I'm a little bit childlike. Because it's really kind of like for the first time in my life, I'm barely learning all these feelings, all these emotions, and it's kind of like scary, kind of embarrassing, because I didn't know nothing else growing up but like rage and anger and hate and all this. So now when I experience joy, happiness, and like kindness, and all these other like weird gushy feely good feelings, like, it just makes me feel childlike. But I'm so grateful that I'm starting to experience it now, and I'm so happy that I'm starting to nip all my bad habits in the butt since now at 22 years old, because I don't want to be 40, 50 years old, like, still stuck doing the same things, you know. And I really feel like God sees that, and God knows my heart, and God knows my mindset. So I feel like that's why he's blessing me now. And when I tell you it has not been easy, it really hasn't been no peaches and cream and ice cream rainbows. It really hasn't. It's been a hard journey, and I'm just so ready for this. Oh, this is what I was gonna say. Like, you guys, when I had my Mazda, like, yes, I was so grateful, but now this car is such a fucking upgrade. And so is this apartment. Oh my god. Like, you guys, like, honestly, I feel at peace now. I just feel like everything matches. Like, I have an apartment, a car. Like, I just feel so, like, at ease with adulting. I don't know I don't know how else to explain it, but I just feel set now. I just feel like I can sleep, and that's exactly what I'm about to do. So I think I'm gonna leave you guys off with this. I'm gonna send pics, and I'm gonna take pics, and I'm going to post stuff tomorrow. Right now we're gonna go ahead and watch my Netflix. So you guys have a blessed one, and good night. We'll see you tomorrow when we get the car. Okay, bye. What's up, chat? I don't know why I'm holding my fucking towel like this. But you guys, I just got out the shower. I gotta go pick. Well, good morning. Let me start off by saying good morning. It's probably like 10 o'clock in the morning over here in Albuquerque, New Mexico. But you guys, I have to go fucking pick up the money and go get my car. You guys. Like, you guys, this is really fucking happening. This is really fucking happening. You guys, oh my god. Like, I am so fucking grateful. Like, God knows, I'm gonna pray to fucking God. I don't want to cry. Let me lock in. You guys, it's almost time to go get the car. So, I just got out the shower. I'm gonna get ready. I'm gonna do my hair so we can take pics. I have to go pick up the money, and then we're gonna go get the car today. You guys. So, I'm gonna get ready, and I'll touch back in with you guys when I'm done getting ready. Okay, bye. Guys, it's T minus like an hour to get the car. Of course I'm bringing my biggest fucking bag. Let me try it out before I show you guys the outfit. Hey guys, so my phone kind of, gave out or whatever. But this is this is the outfit. I'm bringing my biggest bag because we want these people to know I got money. And plus, we gotta be flashy because this is like a big girl purchase, you guys. We got the balloons. I wanna bring the balloons out, so we're gonna take pics. But this is the outfit. This is what it's giving. Do you guys like my Halloween stuff? But yeah, you guys. But listen, this is a big purchase, a real big girl purchase, like done professionally in my name. It's gonna be straight. You guys, I'm just really excited. It's T minus like not even an hour. We're probably gonna go get some Bob's Burgers before because I'm so fucking hungry. But other than that, you guys, the next time I see you, I will be in the car. Okay? Love you. Bye. You guys, what the fuck did I tell you? The next time I see you, I will be in the fucking car. And bitch, I done fucking got my car, bitch. We fucking rolling home. Ah, we rolling, bitch. We rolling.
Oh my god, here it is, you guys. That's dark.
So yeah, I'm just waiting for Michelle, and then that's it. Okay. You guys, oh my fucking god. You guys. Oh my god, let me see the fucking radio. I don't know if it fucking works. Oh, it does. 100 hours. The radio does work. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay, you guys, I got my car. Here it is. We got some balloons. Oh my god. The balloon just flew away. I did not try that one tight enough. I know I didn't, but we got some balloons here. So I think we're just gonna take some pictures really quick and we'll be back. Thank you. So I'm halfway home. I'm fucking halfway home. I told you guys I'm gonna fucking get this car. I told you. The only thing that I don't like is that in the back windshield is like there's hella fucking bumps. I mean, there's hella fucking bugs in the back, you guys. But yeah, we're driving home now. I'm gonna flip the camera. But yeah, let me get off this car. Let me get off the phone because I don't have no fucking registration or nothing. But you guys, we got the fucking car. Can you believe that? Okay, bye. I'm about to edit this video and post it tonight, same day, you guys. I'm just so grateful God has blessed me. I have my AC on, so it might be a little bit loud, but you guys, oh my God, that ride home, coming home, I told you I was gonna get the car. I fucking told you guys. But that ride home, oh my God, was just like so good. It felt so good to be back on the road. You know, I brought my dad with me. You know, this is like really like the first time like something in my life like has gone right. And like I was smoking weed, sorry. And I'm just like, wow, God, I could get used to this. I could get used to this because things have always gone wrong. And when I go through stuff, I really go through it. And it's really bad, and it's really like a journey and a trial. But this time was like a journey and a trial, but in a good way. And I really feel like God has been testing me this whole summer. And excuse me. And I just really feel like this is just God's way of showing me how good it's gonna get. Like, oh my God, I can't believe I got a car. I'm still in shock. Like, driving home, just looking at my hand and driving, like, it's weird. Like, I can't believe it's happened so fast. Because last week, I was just down bad, so bad. Like, crying, saying, God, please get me a car. I just can't believe this is still happening. And I just want to say thank you so much to all my support. All my friends who have gotten me through. Who have been there, like, through this time. Because the ones who are close to me, like, y'all know. Y'all see me struggle. Y'all see me down in the dumps. And now I could just sleep at night. Now I could just breathe. It's like, wow, I still can't believe this is happening. And I really feel like, I don't know, like, I'm telling you guys, like, things have gone so bad in my life. Things have not worked out for me. And I really just feel like this is God's way of showing me, like, life is about to get so good for me because I don't want to cry. Because, like, I'm just, like, starting to see that, like, I'm so deserving. But I don't want to cry on this live. I don't want to cry. But, yeah, you guys, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks for being a part of this. I'm about to edit this and upload it and go to sleep. So, good night, you guys. And thanks for watching. Bye.